Hey, this is Frank, and this is a 3.5 liter V6 engine, engine code 2GR-FE by Toyota. And I'm going to tell you about a secret design flaw or feature, we'll call it as you wish, that has important consequences both for the power production with this engine and for the reliability of this engine. So keep watching. This engine came out of a Lexus RX350 and it had a blown head gasket. And it's only one of several 2GR-FE engines with blown head gaskets that I've looked at, and some of which I've replaced over the last couple of years. And I came to understand something with these engines is that most of the time the head gasket defect manifested at first as a persistent misfire that never went away. And it happened commonly either on cylinder 1 or cylinder 6. And some other mechanics who work on these engines also made the same observation, that these head gasket faults were occurring either on cylinder 1 or cylinder 6. So we never knew why this was the case, but I'm developing a theory that I'm going to share with you that may explain why we're seeing this happening. I want to start by looking at the exhaust ports for this engine and counting off the cylinders, starting on the timing side. This is cylinder 1, cylinder 2 is over there, cylinder 3, cylinder 4 is over there, cylinder 5, and cylinder 6 is back over there. So now let's look at the exhaust ports. This is cylinder 1, cylinder 3, cylinder 5, and let's see if we can look straight into the exhaust ports. For cylinder 1, if we look straight into the port, only one of the valves is visible. Only one of the exhaust valves is visible. And you can see the divider is over on the right. This is the divider between the two exhaust valves. And the other exhaust valve is over there on the right. Let's compare cylinder 1 with cylinder 3. We're looking straight down the exhaust port for cylinder 3, which is right next to cylinder 1. And looking straight down on this cylinder, both exhaust valves are visible on either side of the divider. Now let's look at cylinder number 5. Again, for cylinder number 5, both exhaust valves are visible. Let's go back again to cylinder number 1. And now you can see how the first exhaust valve closest to the timing cover is offset to the right from the position of this exhaust port. And now we're looking at cylinder number 2. Both exhaust valves are visible looking down the port. And this is cylinder number 4. There may be a slight offset here, but both exhaust valves are easily visible. Let's move to number 6. Uh-oh. Only one exhaust valve. Where's the other exhaust valve? Well, to see it, you have to angle the camera lens over to the left. If you look straight down, the exhaust valve, the furthest exhaust valve, is not visible. So cylinder 1 and cylinder 6 have this feature that you might call a flaw in common. So what are the implications of this? The first implication of this observation is that there is a restriction on the exhaust flow for cylinder 1 and cylinder 6. And I've been told by a very reputable provider that this is a significant restriction that has a negative impact on the power production for this engine. In fact, they say that if you do a good porting job just on cylinders 1 and 6 on the exhaust, you will gain a significant amount of power. But what's the other implication that is more serious for reliability, not performance, but reliability? Okay, I've noted that on cylinders 1 and 6, we often do observe damage to the head gasket. Well, thinking about this, a restriction in the exhaust flow can lead to a higher exhaust gas temperature, a higher cylinder operating temperature. And if the coolant flow does not compensate for this, then there could be an overheat, localized overheat event that causes damage either on cylinder 1 or cylinder 6. And these are the two cylinders that are the most often impacted by the head gasket damage issue. So this is just a theory, and it bears verification. It seems to explain some observations, okay, but that doesn't mean that it's necessarily true. We would have to think about ways to verify this theory, okay? That's the essence of the scientific method, right? I hope that you've enjoyed this video and that you have seen something both entertaining, informative, and useful. Thanks for watching.